Racing to the 2022 Breeders' Cup, and this time we go to the Spa, Saratoga, for the Grade 1 Alabama Stakes. It'll be on Saturday at Saratoga. Fillies will be going a mile and a quarter. It is for three-year-olds, and the field drew a seven-horse field. Let's take a look, starting off at the rail. Scratch Cat comes in 20-1 on the morning line. Going to be a long shot in this spot, going up in class and facing three pretty tough contenders in Gerrymander, Nest, and Secret Oath. Scratch Cat out of the one hole. Goddess of Fire is one of two horses trained by Todd Pletcher, 15-1 on the morning line. Another one, you know, the recent form is not good, and overall her best distance seems to be 7 furlongs to a mile. Gerrymander stepped up big the last time for trainer Chad Brown. A disappointing debut effort at Churchill Downs. 4-1 on the morning line, stretching out and going up in class from a grade 2 to grade 1. Nest is 3-5 after the big victory the last time out. Nest goes for trainer Todd Pletcher. The daughter of Curlin should be good at 10 furlongs. Nostalgic for Bill Mott. She picked up a nice win in the Gazelle earlier this spring at Aqueduct. Tries to win at Saratoga. Nostalgic is another horse that's got a little bit of a shot. I think the bigger field will benefit her and faster fractions also. She's Keen, 20-1 in the morning line, probably going to be 30-1 on the board. And then Secret Oath for Dwayne Lucas. Disappointed last time out, lost to Nest 7-2. She was ridden closer to the pace that time. Louis Saez rides the Secret Oath, the Kentucky Oaks winner in this race. That is a look at your Alabama field. Again, a seven-horse field. A lot of the wagering is going to be on Nest. She's 3-5 morning line. You know, Secret Oath, the last time going into the last race, she was kind of considered equal, and the big drubbing by Nest. But I think a couple of circumstances worked to her advantage that time. It was a small field. Now we get a few more horses. Secret Oath was ridden closer to the lead. I think now she can lay a little bit further back. Also, the track was a little bit demanding that day. I think Nest just kind of made the mid-race move, and nobody was able to close into that. And then late in the game, Secret Oath kind of just ran on for second. Nostalgic, again, not really trying that hard late in the race as well. You know, I think Gerrymander stepped up, but that was against weaker horses. I think she did kind of a surprise attack. Juju's Map was in that race, and a couple of other horses. They showed a little bit more speed, and I think the pace got a little bit out of hand. Gerrymander was able to pick up that. My key questions in this race is the distance. Who benefits from the 10 furlong distance? Secret Oath versus Nest. I think they both got a strong pedigree. Secret Oath by Arrogate, Nest by Curlin. I think that last race, the margin of victory is a little bit misleading. Again, just because of the way the race flow and the track surface that day. I see overall, when you look at a horse like Nest and Secret Oath and Gerrymander, any one of these three are capable with the right race flow to pick up the victory in this race. Early speed, I'm going to give that to a slight advantage to Gerrymander. I think she's going to do better on the front end if they elect to go that route. Pressers, I think that's going to be Nest and possibility of Scratch Cat. And then your closers, you've got Nostalgic and Secret Oath in this spot. You know, I think you can make a case for Nest just being the best filly of this crop. She had a little bit of a rough trip in the Kentucky Oaks. Secret Oath took advantage of the fast fractions, made her mid-race move when a lot of the speed was fading in that race. Meanwhile, you come back last time out, Nest took advantage of the race flow, and Gerrymander improved dramatically in that grade two. You know, we'll see if she can do better here. She won the Mother Goose the last time, now goes into the grade one of the Alabama. Meanwhile, the CCA Oaks, I think, again, that result was a little bit misleading. So I'm not sure we really have a definitive horse who's the best horse in the race. I think with that in mind, I want to go a little bit of a price. Secret Oath may be a little bit over the top, so that's true. I'm going to go with Gerrymander. I think she's improving. I think the fractions will be slow, and I like the last race out in the big victory she picked up the last time out. And I think she can maybe stretch out to a mile and a quarter. I think you can go any one of those three ways. Not totally incomprehensible that Nostalgic could pick up the victory or even a second place finish to finish off that exacta if the race flow comes to her benefit. And we just don't know with a horse like Gerrymander. She may win, she may run off the board. So Nostalgic is one you may want to take a look at in exactas and trifectas. That is a look at the Grade 1 Alabama Stakes from Saratoga. Leave a comment. Who do you like as we get you ready for the Breeders' Cup 2022?